And we have Evan Cameron playing an Imperial Patty Swarm, which is Howlrunner with crack shot, three blacks with crack, and three academies.
Versus our friend Robin McNeil here, who's running a old school, very old school X-Wing and A-Wing list. So you've got Wedge Antilles with Swarm Leader.
That's fun.
That's new. That's really fun. R2 Astromech, Integrated Astromech. Biggs with R4, D6, and Integrated Astromech. And two Green Squadron Pilots with Push the Limit and Chardan Refit.
That Wedge is going to punch like a...
Yeah, that Wedge is going to blow stuff up, that's for sure. And just a quick refresher for those of you who are just joining us. This is a original trilogy tournament. So the rules are such that both players need to bring a Rebel and an Imperial list. Every match is Rebels versus Imperials, so they roll off to see which list they're flying. The only ships allowed are those ships that appeared in the original trilogy. For Rebels, that's the YT-1300 and A-Wing, X-Wing, B-Wing, Y-Wing. For Imperials, it's the TIE Advance, TIE Fighter, TIE Bomber, TIE Interceptor, as well as the Lambda Shuttle and the Fire Spray. So that's what we've been watching all day. Every upgrade is available, including stuff from newer waves. The only thing that's currently banned, other than not original trilogy pilots, ships, is twin laser turrets. So no TLTs here today.
Right.
Beyond that, we've got people making up all sorts of interesting lists using old ships along with a lot of new upgrades. So, for example, Wedge with Swarm Leader. We definitely would not have seen that back in Wave 3. But now here it is.
No, and Wedge is going to punch so hard with that Swarm Leader. We very well could see something like Howlrunner get deleted.
In one shot?
In the very beginning of the game.
I would not be surprised. It all depends on exactly how they fly everything here.
Now, with that being said, Evan with his Patty Swarm, he's got those PS1 blockers that he's going to be able to throw out front.
The reason for the TLT ban...
Everyone hates them.
Everyone hates them. Mostly it's just for, I want to say balance reasons. A lot of the older ships tend to not do well against TLTs. If TLTs were allowed, well, that would take out...
B-Wings right
well,
away.
Well, it's always Imperial versus Rebel, so you never have TLTs versus other Rebel ships, but...
Bombers get chewed, fire sprays get chewed.
Yeah, bombers, fire sprays, Lambda shuttles,
TIE
all
fighters
get chewed.
Get chewed up.
Yeah. Basically, it's just to encourage a wider variety of potential lists. We don't have everyone just running four TLT Y-Wings.
Yeah.
So that's the reason for the ban.
Which we would have really seen, right? I mean, you would have seen, I think, a fair number of TLT. You'd see Thug Life, or the equivalent of...
The Rebel version, yeah. Basically. Yeah. So we just wanted to try and make sure that the... that people were free to do what they wanted. Nothing got pushed out by one particularly powerful upgrade. TLTs are powerful. They're not, like, in the larger meta, super powerful nowadays.
No, they just push a lot. They make a lot of stuff unplayable.
Yeah.
It's not that your top meta usually worries over much about them.
Yeah.
But a lot of your middle of the field,
drops
should I take this or not,
bottom.
It cuts out a lot of those options. Mm-hmm. Where you're like, instead of running an X-Wing, a T-65, I'm now probably going to take an A-Wing with auto thrusters.
Right, exactly.
Just in case.
So the idea is that you want to have more variety. So here we are without TLTs. And I don't think I don't think it's been a negative experience at all. There have been a lot of interesting lists so far. So I'm excited to see how well this one plays. Biggs will keep Wedge alive, in theory, while the green squads, it looks like he's setting them up to come from a different angle, which is actually probably the right choice. With Swarm Leader, the people you're taking the evades off don't have to be anywhere near your Swarm Leader.
TLT... So the question is, what would fix TLTs? Maybe a two dice?
Good question.
Maybe. The other idea that I've seen throw around is you only get the second shot if you miss the first. So it's almost like a built-in gunner type turret.
Yeah, but then is it worth it?
No.
Does it become worth 6 points at that point?
Well, what it becomes then is you might want to lower it to 5, because then it's that or an ion.
Yeah.
And then maybe.
Hmm. I don't think TLTs are really going to get a nerf anytime soon.
Neither do I.
They're not super dominant. And here's the thing about any larger meta. There's always going to be things that are on top and things that are on the bottom.
Right.
So that's normal. It's not unhealthy. It becomes a problem when it's just one thing that's on top the entire time. There's been a little bit of that lately with, say, Jump Masters, or whatever, say, at Worlds, where 13 of the top 6 are...
It is pretty easy to fly. James, so the question saying it's not really that OP, it's so easy to fly against.
Well, that's the thing, right? Because they do have that donut hole, so there is that weakness there for a lot of, that a lot of other ships can exploit. So, I don't think TLTs are, like, hugely overpowered. We just decided to ban them here so as to encourage a different approach to list building.
Yeah, people taking, instead of your TLT golds, taking, you know, odd B-wings, different X-wings that you just don't see that often.
We saw someone flying Kian Farlander earlier.
Right. And that's really what the purpose of it was.
Mm-hmm.
I agree that I don't think something like the equivalent of Thug Life is overly meta warping.
Not anymore. It was for a while back when TLTs first came out, I guess.
Right.
But that's kind of changed.
And even then, I don't think a TLT is ever that big of a problem. It's you always, would always see them in large groups. And just similar to a Jumpmaster a lot of the times. I don't think one Jumpmaster is really ever a problem. Or most people would say that a single ship has really ever been the problem. It's the fact that when you throw three of them in a list...
Yeah.
They become very, very strong.
Yeah. I'd say the one is only the issue when in mind link lists.
Right.
But that's a whole other...
Yeah, then it's an argument. It's a combination of mind link and the jump.
I still think my personal opinion on is that the common denominator in all of those all those lists that are very powerful is that the jump master is just too cheap.
Yeah.
Right. But we're not worrying about that today because there's no scum allowed in this tournament. Original trilogy tournament only, which is Imperial and Rebels only. No scum. We just get to see some classic X-Wing ships doing their thing.
This is an interesting match.
So it's interesting. He's actually bringing the...
I agree. Yeah, I mean, the comment that a TLT swarm is boring, I 100% agree.
They're not particularly fun to fly against, or even fly. I mean, there's some...
There's some nuance with it where you've got to worry about overlapping arcs, etc., etc. But it's not... You're right, it's not the most engaging thing in the world to fly in the game.
Mm-hmm. But I personally like having, like, one in a list, right?
Oh, yeah.
They make great fillers.
Now, one thing I would say is if you haven't gotten the chance to fly against it yet, flying against the PS5 Aggressor TLT is different.
I'm curious to fly against that, see how that works, because they are more dynamic ships. They move around more, that's for sure.
I don't think it'll become meta or anything like that, but it's not bad. Why do you think Robin didn't take A-Wing test pilots for a couple free?
Good question. He's got just push the limit and chart and refit. Why not A-Wing test pilot and trick shot, for example, or...
I honestly don't know.
Yeah,
He may not have had the cards. Could be one.
It's probably it. Or he just didn't think about it. But yeah, trick shot on... There's no reason not to put trick shot on those guys.
Right.
Right?
Oh, adaptability.
Yeah, or even adaptability. Adaptability can be great on those guys because you can...
Force, they're the same as the TIE fighters.
Yeah, you can bring them up or bring them down if that's necessary. But no reason not to have adaptability on them.
Yeah, so why do I think I either didn't think about it or didn't have the cards.
Yeah.
There is no right. It's an oversight.
Probably an oversight, yeah. Oh, well.
To be fair, though, he got here, so...
Yeah, he's here in the top four, so he's been doing well all day with that.
And I know his Imperialist is actually a crack swarm, which he does... He has been flying quite frequently.
Uh-huh.
So that's probably the list he has more reps with. He could have had this list as more just an afterthought.
Right. Actually, he might have even been one to borrow the one X-Wing. I heard someone asking to borrow an X-Wing.
I think he was actually looking for another. I don't think this was his original list coming in.
Oh,
I think he made this kind of as a last minute.
Oh,
I couldn't
really?
Find an X-Wing to plug in.
I wonder what he missed.
Well, Wedge Biggs and two ships. I mean, four ships Rebels is not a bad call.
No, no. And as long as he can keep Wedge alive, that... That swarm leader can be really nasty.
Right. The question, this being a list he probably hasn't flown that often,
mm-hmm.
is he going to be able to keep them together?
But
what's
again,
the right way to fly it once you get out of it a little bit?
You keep,
once you're turning them around.
You keep the two, what's the word I'm looking for?
A-wings.
You keep the two X-wings together and the two A-wings together, because
yep.
again, the A-wings don't need to be near Wedge; they just have to have the same target in arc.
Right. But then your A-wings become susceptible to just getting ripped off the board by a whole bunch of TIE fighters shooting.
Yeah, they are A-wings. A-wings can be a little slippery. It's a shame there was no room for auto thrusters here.
PTL
but,
too, right?
But
I mean,
with
like,
PTL, they focus evade every turn. That can keep them alive.
Yeah, this could be a. For all we know, he could have. Ebayed the cards, right, and just not had the other ones.
Mm-hmm. It's possible he just forgot. We can
right.
ask him later and find out. find out why. It's also possible, like I know some people were just borrowing ships for other people because they say mostly play Imperials, mostly play Rebels, whatever. Given the nature of the tournament, where you needed to bring an Imperial and a Rebel list, a lot of people are playing things that they might not. Might not be super familiar with using all the time.
Right. Yeah, I mean, he is, I think, fairly new to the
game. Oh, yeah.
And he's been focusing more on Imperials
well, there you
with
go.
A crack swarm. So he might not have even been familiar with the Rebel list
mm-hmm.
to build out, other than these fit together really easily. PTL is a great card. They've
Get
got
grown.
A good dial, lots
yep.
of green.
Yeah, I hope he didn't put them too close to the edge of the board here. But it looks like
One
he
hearts.
Is going to... Yeah, hard one with them, and then they will be a little farther back, sure, but he then has options to attack this swarm from two different angles.
Which might be how he wants to approach it,
yeah.
to be honest. I would think about maybe hard turning these and keeping the X-Wings going to the top of the board and
mm-hmm.
bringing these A-Wings down towards the bottom and splitting them fully apart
mm-hmm.
to try to split that swarm.
Yeah, that's what I would do as well. Split the swarm, make them deal with you in that way.
The only thing that I think might be a little difficult, obviously, is the A-Wings can move really quickly.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're not familiar with it, you can kind of overreach with the A-Wings,
mm-hmm.
and the X-Wings will take a little bit of time to get back in
yeah.
play.
Yep. No, no one straights on those A-Wings.
Right.
Yep.
And I know Evan is one of our... long time, extremely good PTL players, but I do know he does not play crack swarms. I believe he said this would be his second time he's ever played it.
Well, that's interesting.
So, flying seven ships for the second time promises to have some difficulties. Given that if he flies a lot of hard turns, it's okay. Looks like we saw a hard one and a boost, and I don't see, and number four is just marked. So you're going to see another hard one,
mm-hmm.
followed by a boost.
Interesting choice. So, Magma Lego and Games just says, what is happening? Can you be more specific? What are you wondering about here? Have you been following along with the tournament? This is a 401 Games original trilogy tournament here at 401 Games here in Toronto.
So the lists are different. Given a Patty Swarm, which is another name of what Evan's flying.
Where's that name come from?
The person that actually made
this version. Was Patty?
Yes, on the forums. I think he was on Reddit. It's good, you know, because there was that, and then there's the very common Black Crack Swarm, where you fly the 6-ship with Howl Runner, usually in maybe a Zeta Leader, which is something that, like, Dallas Parker flies.
This is actually three, and one, and Howl Runner has Crack as well.
Yes.
And three Academy Pilots. Interesting. Right. So you've got three for blocking and three for being crack swarmy. Okay, so it looks like there's going to be no engagement this round, but next round we will most likely have that happening.
Yeah, Evan's going to want to book in on the next round because he might be able to catch Robin without having a lot of ships with arc. You know, like those A-Wings, he has a chance of having a little separation here.
Yeah. It's a really tough choice. I think Wedge wants to go for Howl Runner, but like...
Howl Runner's way in the back.
Yeah, he's just gonna... The problem here, which one's Biggs, which one's... I think he just moved Biggs.
Biggs is going to be that one. He just moved Wedge, right? Wedge will always move last.
Oh, right. Yeah. Right, what am I thinking?
So this is where I see the problem. We're gonna see combat next round, and those A-Wings are not gonna be in a great spot. Regardless,
remember, they don't necessarily need to shoot... because he wants to do the swarm leader shenanigans. They just need to be in a position, like if they're at range 3, and as long as they have that thing in arc at range 3, they can do their swarm leader stuff. And really, they're probably more effective passing off their evades for a swarm leader than shooting two dice at range 3 themselves.
Right. I see something now, though, with sort of thinking he's going to do, what, a 3 bank?
With Biggs?
With those A-Wings?
Oh. Yeah, maybe.
Versus if Evan does like a 2-forward.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're going to be in...
No, you do 3-bank with the A-Wings and then boost them into position if need be.
Then they don't have evades. Oh, they have push.
Yeah. And I'm betting... So what I would do is 2-bank with Biggs, 1-bank with Wedge.
Yep. Yeah, I agree.
And then 3-bank with the A-Wings.
Yeah. To try to catch them up.
Yeah. Or maybe even hard 3.
Maybe. Like, you'd have to worry about the round after.
Yeah. Because remember, the Green Squadrons, as long as Wedge is alive and shooting, the Green Squadrons don't need to shoot.
Yep.
They just need to have something... So they don't need to worry about getting range 1, they just need to have something in range 3.
Yes. Now, with that being said, though, Biggs is going to eat it. Like...
Those Crack Swarms, there's 4 Crack Shots on there that can kill most of Biggs.
Yeah, like Biggs is going to take a lot of fire, which he's meant to do.
Mm-hmm. That's what he does.
But you are more or less now deciding to joust a crack swarm.
Which is never...
it's not usually advisable. It's not in pot. Like, certain lists now can out there joust a crack swarm and do okay. Mm-hmm. But it's not... usually your strategy you want to take. You typically want to pull them into the rocks, make them break formation, and then go in from different angles. Versus he is coming in kind of face on.
Yeah, this is a weird choice.
Said I think I probably would have slow rolled this and taken the A-Wings up down and just play it long. You only have to kill a couple, and if you can stay alive, you're okay.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. So he's going in
hard, which means Biggs is going to take a lot of range 1 shots this round.
Yeah.
Unless he did something crazy like 4K with Biggs or Wedge. You don't want to do that, that's for sure.
No.
Bank with Wedge. 4K, he'd have like number, he might have number 7 here in arc, but it's still not, it's not a good idea.
No.
I was just curious, what would that do? No, that would be no good.
No, because then you're actually giving the swarm the out of just one harding the next round.
What are the A-Wings doing? So, hard 3s.
3 hards.
Okay. Yep, so they're going to focus evade, I imagine. Maybe even boost evade.
I would get more guns right now. I would...
Bank boost. If they bank boost, as long as they stay within range 1 of Biggs, they'll be fine.
Right.
What is that? Is that a focus or an evade? It's an evade, it looks like.
Yeah. I would push for focus. push our target lock. You have a target lock?
They do.
Might as well. I would. They're not getting shot. You might as well maximize your chance for crits or hold it for the following round.
True. No, he's boosting. Trying to get.
So he's really setting up this swarm leader.
Yeah. Well, that's interesting. Oh, I guess he wants to make sure he's caught Howlrunner. Right? Because if Howlrunner moves up, then. Yeah, so you do the same thing. You evade, push, boost.
Just gonna bump. You can't.
You cannot boost.
That's a problem.
Not necessarily.
No, just for this first.
Oh, he can just boost forward. Sure. Yeah.
That's gonna be. Well.
Actually, that's not necessarily a bad thing. If you can split up the A-wings and have them come at different angles, that's always good.
Like, this is just one of these things where it's just not usually common strategy to go in face-to-face with a Krax.
No. No, what I would do next turn is run one of these A-Wings just right into the swarm, just to cause bumps and so on. I would just...
He'll actually move first, though, with his PS1.
Yeah, that's the thing. I would try and get... I would drop the A-Wing right where the PS1s are right now.
Yeah.
So Biggs doing a one bank. Actually, the one bank is smart because that keeps him at range two.
Yep.
I think.
Yeah, it is. Mm-hmm. Definitely. And then you should bring Wedge in with a little stronger if you can range one Wedge.
Well, Wedge is probably doing a one bank as well, and Wedge is just going to plow into Howlrunner. Now, the real question is does A-Wing number four have Howlrunner in arc at range three?
Oh.
And he might.
I think he might.
That arc looks about right. The question is the range.
Yeah, I think so.
There's that one bank. Because, if you can kill Howlrunner this early on with a 5-dice attack and -1 agility, you do it, right?
Yeah.
You do it. Actually, this is well placed because Biggs is actually at range 3 of the furthest back.
Yeah, and that's actually the downside of the way he was flying that formation, is when you do have to do that turn in and you set up in the longer columns, your back columns tend to be very long on range.
Yeah, and there's a way to fix that as you go, which he just didn't do. I'm pretty sure he could have ended up with a 2x3 in the opposite direction.
Yep.
So Wedge is shooting Howlrunner, range 2. Is Wedge going to use Swarm Leader? Because I totally would.
Not as well.
I would definitely use Swarm Leader here. Yep. So the front one you can use for sure. Can the back one be used? Do you have him in arc? I'm pretty sure you do.
I think so, too. No. Evan's right on this one. He has to be in range of the target to pull it.
Yeah, in arc, range 3. I'm pretty sure. So that one for sure. The question is, looks like.
It still is.
Yeah. They're just going to move that TIE fighter so they can get a better placement of the ruler. I'm pretty sure that A-Wing has arc and range.
Yep,
looks like it. Just barely, but it looks like it.
I think so. I think he's in. We'll see, though.
You do have our judge there. Actually, that's our judge, Billy, who's checking right now.
Flips the corner.
Looks like it to me.
But corner to corner.
Hard to say.
Yep. You can flip it up. He's still fine. You definitely
should. He was. It was. It's.
You should turn it on its side, though.
Are you sure? That might have just been the way it looked on the video because of the 3 thing there. Anyways, we've got 5 dice. Focus for 5 hits.
Wow.
And Howlrunner only gets 2 dice here. Spends his evade and lives. So Howlrunner's down to 1 health. And that is a shame. That is... That's something that Robin really needed was to...
It was a fantastic roll by Robin, though. There wasn't a blank in sight.
Yeah, well, and neither was Howlrunner's, unfortunately. which means all these guys get their free rerolls, which makes them that much more potent, right?
Nothing.
So, now we see how Biggs does against this, all of this.
Poorly. Yeah, now Biggs gets to shoot, though.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Biggs can kill Howlrunner first. Forgot about that Biggs can shoot. Never think about how Biggs shoots.
Ooh, only one. You know, he had the really good roll with the five dice.
Yeah.
I don't think that's...
That's a huge shame, though.
Yes.
If he had managed to get three hits there, he could have killed Howlrunner.
Yep. Yes.
Yeah, oh, yeah, the chances of that roll are so...
Bend those focuses.
Two hits, one evade, big shot. Takes one.
Oh, no, he's firing. Oh, he might as well start blowing crack shots.
Crack shots, so big takes two.
This is, the crack swarm is very good at ripping down bigs with R4D6 because mm-hmm.
you're not doing
overloading
more than two.
Damage.
Yeah.
It's very efficient.
Another two hits. Blanks. Oh, this could be really bad news. This could end very quickly for Robin. If Biggs goes down this turn, the last
tough.
Few shots can attack Wedge.
Yep, at range one.
Yeah. Cracked again.
So Biggs is already down to one health.
So our third crack shot. Focus for two hits. There's an evade.
And crack shot.
Crack is after.
Yeah.
That's a dead Biggs. That
it's
was quick.
Dead
Which means those last three...
are going to range one into Wedge.
into Wedge. This is going to be real bad news. And I mean, they haven't even used the Swarm Leader rerolls.
This is one of these things that you just... You know, he got a really good roll on Howlrunner, and luckily Evan got the good evade. He got the most he could out of it.
But even if Howlrunner died, I mean, it would have been one less shot, I guess, which is good. But it hasn't seemed like those shots have been using those rerolls yet.
No.
But these ones will, that's for sure.
And these don't have crack shots, so...
Mm.
But...
Still, this is bad news for Wedge. Oop. That was...
That was two hits.
I'm pretty sure he knocked the... Yeah.
It knocked the die.
That came out with two hits. Yes. Literally watching this in the camera. Oh, there goes Howlrunner.
From an A-Wing?
From an A-Wing.
Nice.
That's a big deal, actually.
Yay, A-Wing. Well, it means those crack shot... those Academy pilots aren't going to be quite as powerful.
Everything is through a rock. I agree. Your closest point to your closest point is always going to be through a rock.
Yeah, for this situation. Yep. Two hits. We don't have a focus. Two focuses, so nada. That looks like a range two shot.
Yep. It is not a range one. Yeah.
And then two range one shots. Still bad news for Wedge. Okay, so just one hit. Wedge is safe.
Wow.
Wedge is safe.
Wedge's dice are going on fire.
And hit crit. Double evades. Nope, just one. Wedge
That's
takes
fantastic.
A crit, loses a shield.
That was some great defensive rolling by Robin there.
Yeah.
That could have gone very poorly.
Yeah, it could have. So the question is, what's next? So I would K-turn with Wedge, I think. Because these guys all need to move out of the way, so there'll be a perfect spot for Wedge to be, having K-turn, which means they're probably all going to K-turn themselves.
Yeah, they can
so
three.
So I would, what I would do is move A-Wing number three here, hard two with him, right? So he's just behind Wedge, just in a blocking position.
Yep.
Right?
Yeah, I agree.
And then block the whole swarm if they try to K-turn. Right?
Now, given he could start running some of these ships into the back of each other if they want to. So, like, Evan for two and four can just run them into the back of 3 and 6 if he wants to activate first.
But 3...
2 forward will clear. Never mind.
I think
mind.
5, 7, and 3... Yeah, and they don't have 1 forwards, right?
Right, they
don't. They do not. Although, actually, if he activates 2 and 4 first... wait, what's... Which ones are which here? 4,
and
4, 4...
He used all of his crack shots.
I think 7, 5, and 6 are our... yeah, 5, 6, 7 are our academy pilots.
Yep.
So they have to move first.
I would probably evacuate these guys, and then maybe do a 1 hard on that guy.
So that you could move 2 forward and with number 2 and get him stuck behind number 3?
Yeah, because it'll start blocking K turns for Wedge, right?
Yeah, that's such a tricky... We'll see if he thinks about it, but it's very much a tricky set of maneuvers he would have to pull off in order to keep a TIE fighter in place.
Yeah.
Which is kind of silly. But
it's not really what they do.
No. But if he's 3King with 5 and 7, they'll make it no matter what. Actually, I don't know if the 3K with number 5 would work here, but A-Wing number 3...
Robin's actually not in a bad spot. We'll see if he realizes he's got the maneuvers to actually make it a pretty good run. But he's...
If he can block the K-turns and get wedged behind the whole swarm, that's bad news for the entire swarm.
Yeah. Yeah, because Wedge can chew up a swarm.
Yeah.
I mean, given this is non-regen,
mm-hmm.
2-dice Wedge.
Mm-hmm.
May want
to
start. So if Robin lays out an A-Wing in an obvious spot, he may want to start laying fire into those with his PS4s to try to pull that evade token.
Yep. Yeah, for sure.
Because otherwise he's just going to keep swarm leadering.
But remember, swarm leader Wedge shoots first, so Wedge gets to choose.
Oh, that's true.
That being said, he might be hesitant to pull the evade token off. When
you can go downhill really fast.
When an A-Wing is getting focused down. That being said...
A-Wings against TIE Fighters are not... that's not a bad matchup for your A-Wings.
No, it's not. And if Wedge gets that extra die on his shot, his chances of killing a TIE Fighter in one shot are so much better, right?
Yep.
I think you always, basically always want a Swarm Leader if you can.
Yeah.
Which is a big if here, because do you just start blocking?
I think you want to start making up the damage. You're right. Like, you want to start swarm leadering as much as you possibly can.
Oof, this is tough, but I would probably K-turn with Wedge. I would actually bring number 3 up, to bank him up into where 5 and 7 are now. They're going to be gone.
I would sloop him around the other side.
And number 4 comes 3 banks around the side.
One hard him. Get him out of here one hard in. Because if these things are all going that way,
that's
not
true.
Bad.
That's true.
Now he's going to stay stressed, though, is the problem. One hard's not green on an A-Wing.
Yeah, no, you need a green because you really want to...
Swarm leader. But that would set you in a really good spot.
Mm.
Like, maybe you take the one round of not great for... Again, then you'd have a TIE swarm split with one ship behind and one ship in front, which is not bad.
This is tricky. I think you really want to do a green maneuver, though.
I do, too.
Two straight, and then you can boost and evade, or whatever, if you need to.
Yeah.
But 2 straight with number 4. Number 3, I would... Does 2-bank put you on the rock? No, it doesn't. I would 2-bank towards the swarm, because 7 and 5 are going to be gone. You get to go right in there and then be in a bump position for 2, 4, 3.
Yep.
What do we got? K turns. K turns. Is it 4K? It's 4K for these guys.
Yeah, so he's 4K.
Yep. So I assume Wedge has done the same. The risk with that, with bringing in the A-Wing to where 5 and 7 just were, is... If somehow he does some shenanigans with the Black Squadrons, Wedge could get blocked.
Right here could be not nice.
Yeah.
Because you could start gumming things up, right? Like a one hard and then just them moving forward.
Yep. Oh, that's a...
Two hard. So he's broken his form, which makes sense. No Howl Runner, no need to stand formation.
Yep. although which this means he's not committed to blocking Wedge, right? Which means that's a good thing if Wedge did the K turn, like I think he's
which
going
I'd
to
imagine
do.
He
yeah.
did.
Right? You K turn with Wedge and you just pull off that shot. So this guy's doing a what is that? Two straight? Three straight. Also green.
Yep. Probably would have done two, to be honest.
Yeah, because two and a boost put you right next to the rock.
Right.
And gives you a position to shoot two, three, or four if they're only going a little bit forward.
Three might put him in a really... It was just a little too aggressive, I think. Because even the boost now, it's not that it's bad.
Yeah, now he's too close to the rock. Yeah, that's not a good spot. Like, he could be...
But a 2-4 is going to keep him out of arc.
Yeah.
Like...
I mean, he'll be out of arc, but he also has no swarm leader-ishness. Because these guys are all moving out of the way. I wouldn't even bother evading here. What do you do? Focus evade?
He pushed.
Or sorry, push for a...
Is this a
4 straight? What's going on here?
Yeah. I think I see a 4 straight.
That's an interesting move. So he's committed to not getting a swarm leader shot this turn. I think he just bumps that black squadron.
No, I think he's in.
Nope, he makes it. How about that? So he's there to gum up the rest of the moves. Oh, which means number 4 might get a shot if red 4 ends up blocking the black squadron, ends up getting blocked by his own ships. The problem with doing what he's doing here, though, is if 2 and 3 get blocked, then there's no room for Wedge to
K-turn. Won't fit, and he'll be just stressed at that point.
But maybe he thought about this, and maybe Wedge is just doing like a 2-4 or 1-forward or something. Oh, no, he's getting out of there. What is he doing? Maybe he's just hoping to come around again. He's really just not taking advantage of this round.
Yeah, he had nice positioning. Like, he could... Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe we're not seeing it. Maybe I'm oversimplifying or something.
Oh, no. Wedge is too harding out.
But No. It's,
okay.
These guys now.
He is going...
3 hard.
He bumps.
Nope. He gets passed.
Oh, wow.
But see, this is interesting. Yeah, I really hope Wedge did a K-turn. Like, I really, really hope. And actually, boosting out was probably a good idea, because now these guys are all facing the wrong...
Making 3 Ks on these. He's going to be in this K-turn. Though I've got to admit, the K-turn on Wedge is going to pump in. I'd assume he K-turned.
Yeah.
Like, 90% sure he's probably 4K in here.
These just 2 straights...
Yeah.
I really don't know what either of these guys is doing.
No, that blocks it. He won hard.
That blocks that K-turn. Yeah.
Though, okay, so it blocks it to the extent that number 4 is just going to get shot with a range 1.
Yeah, and Wedge is going to bump into number 2.
Yeah, like,
I don't know if the K-turn doesn't make it. The K-turn might make it.
This is one of these things where I feel
like...
What
is that?
4? That doesn't look like a K-turn.
It's a 2 bank?
Oh.
So he was just expecting the block.
Which, I mean, is fair.
Yeah. It's hard to tell if a K-turn would fit there. It might have fit. But now he's just getting shot at by these two academies.
His A-wing is going to get wrecked.
I don't know. It's a weird set of choices here. Turns out Robin ends up in a situation where he has very few shots. The A-wing's fine. He only has 1 shot at him. Oh, maybe 2. 4, maybe 6. Yeah.
Well, and 7 if he wants. It depends on how much he wants to really, like, try to burn down this A-wing, what he wants to shoot. They were interesting.
Aaron Shea says, fuck, those are interesting moves. I'm like, yeah? Not what either
disagree.
Of us expected. Yeah. You were definitely expecting that K-turn.
See, the way that I see it is that 4K wouldn't have been a bad block. Like, okay, he would have blocked that with number 2.
But he would have went into number 2. Number 2 gets no shot.
He would have just unloaded range 1 into number 4.
Yeah, exactly.
That would have been a great, like, block away. Wow. Is that an A-wing?
That someone shot an A-wing.
No, that's not Howl Runner. That was Evan? Those wedges shot. No wedge can't shoot.
Yeah, it was. It was one of the black squadrons. I think number four shooting number three. I think that's what that was.
I think that's out of luck. Yeah.
So A-wing number four has nada. And the PS1s, we've got a one shot here against that A-wing, who has an evade token and three dice, who would probably be fine.
Yep. Oh, wow, yeah, he's fully evaded up.
Two hits and...
takes a damage.
Yeah, one evade, so number three loses one health. Yeah, so Aaron Shea says he thinks it might have been better to do the 4K and get blocked. I think we
agree.
At least then Wedge would have had a perfect shot at
number four.
And Swarm Leader even would have kicked in. So we would have had range one shot. So four dice, five dice, because you could get Swarm Leader. Unmodified, sure. But then he's only got two agility.
Yeah,
right?
As silly as this sounds, one of the things that's a problem now is Biggs is worth more than the Howler. So Robin's down on points.
Mm-hmm.
So like this would be kind of one of these things where the block would have been nice, and then you disengage, but you do have to worry about how much you're disengaging.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So the question is, what happens this turn? Right. This is where things get really interesting, because this current position is not even remotely what I expected. So these two TIE fighters at the bottom here are stressed. They can just like two forward or something like that.
They're fine.
This guy, number three, he's going to K-turn, probably. Whereas I'm betting number three will K-turn. I'm betting number six will like one bank. Does he have one banks or no?
Okay, so he'll have already moved. You know, they've got only one hards.
And okay.
And then twos and two banks.
Yeah, where would you go? You might even one hard with him then.
Good 3K.
Although these guys move after the A-wings.
Yep.
So never mind. A-wing's out of the way.
I wonder if he's going to run his A-wing. If I were Robin, I would think about maybe pulling out and reforming.
Regrouping?
Up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because those A-wings are a lot easier to pull back into formation. And he can let Wedge be on the... Like you said, with the Swarm Leader, he doesn't need to fly them close.
No.
They just need to be an arc. So he can swap... Like, he can pull away now and run Wedge by himself and the A-wings by themselves.
You know what I would do here, actually, is I think I would K-turn Wedge and hard one A-wing number four.
Yep.
Right? Oh, no, that's stress. A hard two then. Although then you bump into...
But you've cleared your stress.
And that TIE fighter.
I don't think you'll get a lot of shots that way. He's two forwards. Yeah, you will.
Yeah.
You want to be careful. Maybe you... some bank... Two bank, maybe.
Two bank, and then, oh, you know what? If you two bank, you clear your stress, and then you boost down, and then you can get number three, who's going to do that K-turn. You can get him in arc, right?
Yeah, I think I would try to push less.
And you might block number four, wherever he's going.
I'd Swarm Leader when you can, but don't force yourself to fly in a predictable manner.
No.
To do it.
No.
You probably have...
Wedge is plenty powerful on his own. If you can get those extra dice, fantastic. If you can't, oh well. Here's an interesting question. Was Sabine's TIE allowed in this? It's an original trilogy ship. It's a TIE fighter.
No.
No, I imagine not. Yeah. There were no rebel TIEs there.
A fine argument? No.
No. But I do like Sabine's TIE in Swarm Leader lists. She can hang out. She can get those evades. She's just
Ahsoka's great with it, too. Because
you
just evade, and it's just a factory.
Yep. No one.
Not to mention, then you can run Seismics, too. it's terrible. No.
But I'll just be thankful that Sabine's TIE can't take Bomblet Generator.
Oh, the crane with the bombs is still not pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
This will be an interesting turn. He's he's going to have to start, Robin's going to have to start being a little aggressive. Not too aggressive, but he needs to keep in mind, though, that his A-Wings have some shields. And Evan's TIE Fighters
do not.
Yeah. Like, it's okay to line up some sketchy moves from time to time to try to rip something off the board.
A-Wing number three probably just wants to left. Yeah. You might get a range one shot on that TIE Fighter who K-turns.
Yep.
Or a TIE Fighter who runs away. That way he clears his stress. It's not a bad move.
No, I like that.
So, what do we got going on?
3K.
Do they have 3Ks?
Oh, that one, 3Ks, yeah. TIE Fighters have 3 and 4Ks. And
wait,
then
is number 6
straight.
A...
That must be the PS1.
What?
Oh, number 3, I think, is a PS4.
Oh, we've got them confused. Yes, right, of course, 6 and 7. Yep. Yeah. So 3K from him. Yeah, that makes sense. To bank. That's an odd choice.
He's hoping this A-Wing blocks.
Well, he's just trying to get the A-Wing? I don't see. If he had gone too straight, at least he'd have some shots on wedge. Yeah, I guess he's just
hoping.
He's
going after the A-Wing.
Mm-hmm.
I would have gone after Wedge. He's still just a 2 agility.
Yeah, yeah. If you kill Wedge, the firepower of this list disappears.
Yeah.
Okay, so this A-Wing's just running.
He's playing him like an ace. It's not a bad idea.
Hmm.
The problem, yeah, it's just not a bad call. I would boost here.
Boost evade?
Boost or barrel roll?
They can't barrel roll.
Oh, so then I would boost.
Yeah, only Jake can barrel roll when you get a focus.
So
he's trying to reform them, basically.
Yeah, I would have boosted one forward, yeah. I think, over the bank.
So what do you think's happening with this other A-Wing here? Two bank, clear stress?
Two bank.
Yeah.
He might three bank it. Robin plays pretty aggressive.
But three doesn't clear stress.
Oh, then to two bank.
Yeah.
I would definitely be clearing stress here. He really likes doing this push with the evade, and he just doesn't need it. He's not going to catch anybody on arc. He didn't need to.
No, but, he's also going to take a couple range three shots, right?
Mm, true.
And that's the question. At range three, actually, I think with four dice, it's better to...
Focus.
First two dice shots, yeah, definitely better to focus than take an evade. But this one, yeah, you focus evade. That makes perfect sense because someone's going to end up in your arc, and Wedge is totally 4K-ing here.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is interesting
3K.
Because Evan's left, so another 3K, but the only people who are in place, I wonder if number 4 is going to K-turn over the rock.
I think so.
It's quite possible.
I think so.
But if he does, yep.
Yep. Oh, did he 3K over the rock? Why did he do that versus a 4K? I would have wanted more space. Oh no, one heart is going to be okay.
Where did he go? Did he K-turn? No, he just went straight.
Oh wow.
He's safe from the rock, but no actions for him, which means Wedge, who's probably K-turning, has a nice target. This guy's three banking. So the problem here is now he's only got a few guys who are in position to go after Wedge next turn.
Right.
Well, I guess 7 and 5 could hard two next turn.
Yeah, that's the thing with TIE Fighters, they can pull in really quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Where you kind of, you typically want to approach like your TIE Swarm from the diagonal because they hard turn in.
Mm-hmm.
They do not bank overly well.
Mm-hmm.
And with him all split apart right this, like the thing we need to remember at this point is it's just a TIE Fighter.
Yeah.
You know, like we're seeing, it's going to be agreed.
Yeah. It's a good thing.
4K.
I guess. Yeah, there's the 4K, which is perfect. Means Wedge can start picking off these ties, right? So
he's
Wedge is going
to
shoot
fast, though, because you're going to see one hard, and you're going to see ships come in the next turn.
Yeah, so one hard from 5 and 7. Although, the A-Wings are in the wrong position to block.
Yeah, this
so
isn't...
The only one you can shoot is number 5. You can't swarm leader. So you've got your 3 dice. You've got a target lock? Where'd that target lock come from?
You got it last turn.
Yeah.
Oh, it's on 2, though.
Oh, yeah. So 3 unmodified dice, range 3 against 3 hits. Versus
paint, he's fine.
Oh no. And see, that's the problem, right? That's why you really need those swarm leader shots so that you can really push that through.
Apparently. I mean, like, it seems like Robin's dice roll pretty hot, and Evan's dice roll enough paint where he's got the action.
That's why you really got to...
You just overload their dice.
Yeah.
Yeah, where you just can't not.
I mean, you... Oh, excuse me. A-wings.
Four of eights.
I mean, you really, really, really want to be...
This could get spicy. Oh, I forgot it's only an A-wing.
Yeah, that's the thing. Just one die,
oh,
right?
There's a blank out. He took one damage.
If only that had happened last round, number five would be off the board. But, c'est la vie. Now the question is, how does he deal with this? What do you do next turn if you are Robin?
Because
you can't one forward with Wedge.
And you can't K-turn your A-wings because he's stressed everything.
Yeah.
He's going to two hard with this.
Yeah. Oh, if he two hards with that, he's in a place to... if he two hards with number three, the A-wing number three...
He can maybe swarm.
He's in place to swarm leader number five or seven if they turn in. Problem is... Wedge is going to land on that rock if he just does a one forward.
He's going to have to one bank.
So Wedge has to bank to clear his stress.
It's not a great
one. Or two forward or even three forward. Actually, if Wedge three forwards...
Yeah, three forward would be good. It'd be pretty aggressive. Land him probably here-ish, maybe.
Yeah. But then he's got four, like, range one shots on him.
Yeah, I don't know. This is tough.
Yeah.
Like I said, this is one of these things where... This reminds me of people that just started playing Push the Limit. Where they push it all the
every
time.
Every single turn?
And,
Which can really limit your dial when you need it to not be limited.
Yeah. And the A-Wings have a good dial, too.
Yeah.
But, like, he could really be using some of the maneuverability of an A-Wing.
I would... I'm almost tempted to say... Because he 4K'd there, right? And didn't pass the rock.
Right.
Which means...
He's going to want to go at least...
I think a two forward would land him on the rock, though. His back corner, probably. Mm-hmm. Maybe the two forward might get him right just past it. And if that did, that'd be a good place to be. Because even if these guys hard two, he would have that range one shot, right?
Yeah, I think you're going to see hard ones.
And then hard one or hard two from the five and seven.
He's going to hard two. He'll hard one.
Hard two from number three. A-wing number three.
Yep.
A-wing number four. I don't know what he's doing. Fractal. Yeah, so Wedge would clear the rock. The question is, if he does a two forward, his template will clear the rock, but will his ship, right? So his base might land, like the back corner of his base might land on the edge of the rock. Three straight would be no problem. Two is a squeaker for sure. Three is definitely clear.
Agreed.
Yeah, that's the question. And I think three is a little aggressive because three he might bump into five or seven. But that's actually not necessarily a bad thing. He gets no focus if he does that, but he also avoids one shot.
Right.
If he bumps into one of them.
Bumping's not about... he doesn't have the ship advantage. Bumping's a good call right now.
Yeah.
You might want the modifiers.
Although the three straight is not a green on...
the X-Wing.
On the X-Wing. It's just the one and two straight and the one banks.
Ouch.
Yeah,
I don't know if I like this at all.
So I think Wedge, I can't tell from here, but if I were sitting there and
that's
it was
a
close
really
call, I would two straight, clear the stress, get myself a focus, hope not to have not bumped anything. And I'm pretty sure he wouldn't bump anything, because even a hard two from these guys, they don't boost, right? Do they boost?
No, they don't boost.
Yeah,
they barrel.
So there's no way they could block a two straight?
No.
The question is whether or not... Wedge lands on the rock. Oh shit, you're right. Aaron mentioned that Wedge has R2. Such an easy thing to forget. I forget that all the time when I run
generic
on
generic droid
things.
When you're out of points.
That does open up some options to him. Problem is, I think he still wants to go two straight. Right? Actually, a two bank. No, that
two bank takes his arc in a weird spot.
Yeah, which means he's got no one to shoot. Wedge really needs to shoot someone this
and
turn.
And the other problem is if he does a two bank, they don't have a one hard. Like, he'd have to two hard at that point, which puts him
well,
in a
have
weird
to go
spot
around.
The following round.
Okay, so here are the one hards that we were expecting.
Yeah, it's in kind of a tough spot right now.
Like, if I were Wedge, I would want to have a shot. Right?
Right.
Because I want to just kill one of these guys before I shoot. Simple as that, right? Before they shoot me. Because the best thing he could be doing is taking a shot off the board.
Three forward. I would have two forward in here.
Oh, yeah, that chap thinks a two straight clears.
I think it's close.
I think it looks close from here, but it's hard to tell from the video. No, I wouldn't hard two out, because if he's hard twoing out, one, it looks like Evan's plan for that with the way six is positioned here. But also, like, he can't spend every turn just running, right?
No,
he's got to start shooting.
Actually, the more I look at that, I think a two straight does clear.
That's the three straight. 3K?
No, he can't because he's stressed.
Oh, he was stressed. Yeah, that's right. So he's just positioning A-Wing number 4 to be behind the swarm for later. He's going to boost behind. Yeah, that just puts him in a better turn to turn around, a better position to turn around next turn.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah. I would not push this turn.
No.
There's no reason.
Here.
He's not getting
it's
shot.
Like, do not push. Because number 4 will bump if he does. A one hard might get him. You might get a really good shot. Actually.
I mean, maybe you target lock. That's a pointless evade. Right?
Yeah. Why would you're not going to have anything in arc.
Yeah, you're not going to have anything in arc. You're not getting anything.
You should have focused at the very least to line up. If he does a two hard here, you'll get a range one shot.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah, that's a weird choice. Maybe he's worried about number 2 here swinging around to be in a shooting position. I don't know. But here you evade. Here you evade for sure.
You can see number 2 since we've got it covering.
Yeah.
Hero 4 facing the edge would be a
Could be a shot. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, for sure. Which is why the evade makes no sense.
Yeah, because Wedge isn't certainly going to have him.
No. And, Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. So what's he doing? Okay, so he's doing
three
hard three.
Yeah, so this is a good... This would have been though where you'd want to take that focus.
Yeah. Why do you evade? Are we sure that's an evade and not a focus?
I'm positive that's an evade and not a focus.
Yeah, that's an evade. So that was a really weird choice. He took an evade he didn't need, and...
He can barrel roll. Evan can barrel roll.
True,
this.
Yeah. Probably what you should do. But he ended up stressed with an evade he didn't need, which is just really not a good choice in the end.
Barrel roll fits this, though.
Yeah. A does not get a shot.
He doesn't.
Not after that barrel roll.
Yeah, and the thing that's kind of nasty about that is that makes it too hard for number 4. Not a great move. So the 4 A-Wing, the 2 hard now, is not going to be in a great spot.
Nope. That effectively blocks.
That was a good move.
Actually, I think he could 2 hard without touching number 4. Because you end up on the same line.
Maybe.
That's tricky. So there's the 2 straight. Here we go.
I think this fits.
Oh, that looks like it fits to me.
Oh, but
hold it tight.
Oh, boy.
That is some tight flying.
It fits. The thing is,
impressive.
Wedge is eating some shots.
Yeah, Wedge is eating some shots. But with Swarm Leader, he could take out one of these guys. Who's taken damage? Number 4 has taken damage. Everyone else. So you shoot number 5. You shoot number 5, you use Swarm Leader, you get 5 dice. Right?
Yeah.
And you've got a focus and a target lock.
Target lock's on number 2.
Oh, right. So you've just got to focus. So it's just 3 hits.
Oh.
2 evades from number 5, and that's no good.
Yeah, it was a good move.
Yeah,
the two forward was a good move.
Yeah, it was. It was close.
And you know, if we were looking straight over it, it might not have been as close. It might have been a bit more obvious that you were going to.
Well, they were holding down the thing, so I think it was pretty close from their perspective as well. But now Wedge eats a whole bunch of shots. Who's shooting here?
Yeah, and there goes Wedge's shields.
Yep. Like, I don't think Wedge is going to survive this turn.
I think he'll survive this turn. I don't think he'll survive the next turn.
Okay, so A-Wing is going to shoot number 5. So it's just 2 dice with a focus.
The thing is, though, is Robin's dice have
hit
been...
Crit.
There's 2 evades. Ooh. But so Evan's dice have been on fire, too.
Yeah.
Like, this has been one where we have not...
Not seen many whiffs.
Yeah.
But this is bad news for Wedge. Yes, Wedge did do a 2-forward.
Yeah. He did clear the street, yeah.
Yeah, but 2-forward is green anyways on on an X-Wing.
So it didn't matter. And it's not R2-D2, if that was the question.
It's R2
it's just a standard R2, so there is no regen. There's another. Right. Yeah, so the question of, was it a 2-forward R2? And I think the idea was a regen. And, not on this list.
No.
Ooh. And now Wedge's dice are starting to fail.
And he uses integrated astromech to discard that crit.
Must have been a direct.
He really shouldn't leave it there. Discard that. Anywho. This is looking really bad for Robin.
Yeah, it really is.
Robin's made some weird choices. I think maybe he's not used to flying Green Squadron pilots.
No, he's been flying the Black Swarm. He's been flying his own TIE Swarm quite a bit. So I think this is just one of these things you see people come in, try things they're not specifically used to.
Yeah,
and he didn't fly it poorly. Like, it's not like he's parking things on rocks.
It's always the trap with PTL, though. It's like, do I want to stress myself out this turn? You got to be careful. Sometimes you don't need to.
Right. Like, number 4 right now, with his evade, is just...
Yeah, why did he do that? No reason for it. He knew he wasn't getting shot. So why that evade?
Yeah.
So Wedge is down to 1. Yeah, Evan's using, what are those?
2016 regional.
Regional dice? Yeah, they're the red. So the paint is either red or green on those white dice.
Yeah.
They're actually really nice.
Yeah, Evan's one of our better players in the league. Especially, I mean, he's definitely one of the common tournament goers. No, they do not show up well on camera. They look pretty washed out most of the time. You can see that if it's paint pretty easily, but you can't tell really what the result is overly well. So the nice thing I've got to say, though, is how do they decide which out of the Imperial Rebelists they're going to play? So the question is, how do they decide which out of Imperial Rebelists they're going to play? What it is to an extent, so it's not like you get to choose. It's not similar to, like, initiative, but you either roll, one player rolls a die, and on hits or crits, they're flying Imperial. And on misses, they're flying Rebel. And then the other player just switches from there.
Yeah. That being said, they have been doing it. So they only do that if they have similar records or if they both played, say, Imperial more than Rebels. But if one player has played Imperial more and the other one has played Rebels more, then the person who played Rebels more plays Imperial that round. And so they try and balance it out like that so that everyone gets to play Imperials and Rebels about equally. So Wedge has 1 health.
which has one health, and he's not K-turning.
What do you do with Wedge? I think I would K-turn with Wedge here.
Yeah, it is. It's been interesting. So the comment that it's awesome to always see Rebels versus Imperials, it has created a pretty interesting time.
Yeah,
to be honest.
So the idea is that it's a kind of a thematic tournament, only original trilogy lists. So again, original trilogies, ships only, the ships that have appeared in the original movies, not the special editions. But you can use newer pilots for those ships, for example, Rey on the Millennium Falcon.
Okay, is so tight.
But it still has to be old ships. Any upgrades are allowed?
Which I think is one of the more interesting things, right?
Because it's not like a Wave 3 tournament. It's an original trilogy plus new upgrades tournament. So it ends up allowing for, some unique things that you wouldn't see in, say, a Wave 3 tournament, which only had old upgrades.
Yeah, so you won't see the things like, the question of why aren't you seeing things like Biggs Walks the Dog or something like that, or Bloody Daggers. Mm-hmm. You do have things like Crack Swarms, and you've got Swarm Leader Wedge that you would never have seen. So it brings back the ships, but it does add a lot of flavor with what upgrades you're taking.
Yeah.
Yes, and no Rebel TIE Fighters.
No Rebel TIE Fighters.
It is nice to see the ships without turrets. I'm not a huge turret fan. I'm not really opposed to them one way or the other, but I have to admit the idea of seeing a bunch of little ships fly around and have to worry about arc and how they have to shoot is kind of refreshing.
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, there are good turreted ships that you still have to fly well. And then there are boring turreted ships that flying doesn't matter so much.
Did that fit?
Yep, that looks like it fit. Yeah.
No, he called that a bump.
Did they? Did they call it a bump?
Not seen in action, so.
Well, he might
think
be.
So. Yeah.
Nope.
No, that fit.
Now he's going to try and boost?
That'll overlap. Yes, the 5Y auto blaster list is just hilarious. Yeah.
So it looks like he cannot boost.
Yes.
That chap is asking a question. Can you use latest unique crew too? Is there a list we can find? So literally every upgrade is allowed. The only thing that we have not allowed is TLT. That is the only card that is banned, only upgrade card that is banned, that is. And then all of the ships must be ships that appeared in the original trilogy. So, again, the YT-1300, and then the A, B, X, and Y wings, and the Lambda Shuttle, Fire Spray, TIE, Advance, Interceptor, Fighter, and Bomber. So any ships or any pilots from any of those ships, even newer pilots like Rey on the Millennium Falcon, that's totally fine. And any and all upgrades are totally allowed. The only thing we were banning were TLT and ships that don't appear in the original trilogy. Simple as that. We didn't want to make it too complicated, just a nice, simple... set of rules, just so that we could have a lot of fun.
I don't know. So what was the point of the boost on A-Wing number 4? I don't know. I don't...
Maybe to try and catch TIE Fighter number 2 in ARC?
I think it's more the thing of, it's somebody using PTL a little bit more than they probably need to.
Yeah.
And
even then, you don't need to boost. Why not focus target lock, right? Have that incredible range one shot fully modified. Although,
it's not.
Yeah, number 4 still had to move, so it turns out it's fine.
Nice. He can just barrel roll, though.
Yeah.
The problem is, though, is Wedge's K-turn is blocked right now by his own A-wing.
Is Wedge K-turning? Or is Wedge just, like, one forward?
Yeah.
I think that's Wedge's move here. You bump into
could
six.
Could he three bank out? Could he three bank left?
Maybe.
Any minimal shots, but like maybe.
I would not have predicted this though. Like the idea of doing a three bank here to come after number two, that would be pretty damned impressive. Yeah, from the sounds of it, three straight. That's just a bump, so he's just going to slide forward, bump into number six, which is kind of fine. It means he gets a shot on number three, range one.
Sadly, number seven's going to light him up.
Seven might not have him in arc. That's really close. They're going to have to check that carefully. I think number three and four are the only ones that have shots.
Yeah, I thought seven did. Somebody will take a look at it, obviously. But
this is bad because Wedge has no...
actions.
No actions.
And
these guys don't have evades. They focus this turn.
I know. Not to mention the number two TIE fighter has just been hilarious. He stayed completely out of the fight for basically the entire game.
Yeah. So who's shooting here? This is Wedge shooting. Someone just took three hits. No, two hits.
Two hits.
Number three, I think.
Yeah. So he's down to one.
Yeah.
But he has no other shots that can come in on him.
No good, though. Wedge is going to die now. Which is a real shame.
Now you fire shirt first with number three, because he's the only... Wedge is the only one who can shoot.
Here's an interesting question. There is only 4 minutes left. But Wedge is, like, I mean, when they finish this round, Wedge is going to die. You have two... You only have 40 points of green squadrons. So even if they live, you need to kill at least two TIEs here. Right? No, you need to kill maybe even three TIEs.
Wedge needs to not die.
Yeah, well, that's not going to happen. Wedge is going to die.
I guess might even be range two, which is just... Well, I mean, like, TIE fighters kind of suck. Ouch.
There's Wedge.
Ouch.
No, he gotcha.
And that's game.
Nope.
As Wedge fails. I'm surprised blankouts haven't happened much in this game, to be honest.
That was, I think, the first one.
Yeah.
Wedge can do it. Wedge dies. So, A-Wing... I would say he has it from this angle.
Too.
Yeah, you've got his corner. You've got that bit of plastic
there.
That's
clipped.
That is... Nope. Our judge rules, no shot. So A-Wing is going to shoot number two, who's taken no damage, which is bad. Spend the focus for hit.
Except for the rare thing, their dice have been so hot in this game.
Yeah.
Like, on both sides. Like, we haven't seen a TIE blank.
So three, shooting four. Really hoping on that shot.
Wow.
Focus. There we go. There we go.
Goodness.
That's it. That kills him. Number four takes a crit. And he's dead. Huzzah. So are they going to start another round? That's a good question. I have a feeling not.
They should.
Well, we're not done quite yet. Oh, yeah. They might have time to start the next round. As long as they have time to start their dials.
That was good.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the A-Wings are slipperier than the TIE Fighters.
Yeah.
Especially with push, they can focus evade every turn.
Yep. Yeah, it's going to be very hard to push damage in all the A-Wings
and
TIE Fighters.
But
a big point difference right now. We've got 76 points left remaining.
The thing is, for Robin to win, Robin needs to kill two of these TIE fighters, right?
Yes.
Because any combination of four of them is more than 40 points.
Yeah.
Which he cannot. So he has to go after number five, who's out of the way.
He's going to have to pop up. Like,
and number three.
Each one's going to have to pop shots immediately, and Evan's going to have to blank.
So number three is going to hard two towards number five, I think. Number four here is going to hard two.
Turn away. At this point, honestly, I would just run if I were Evan. So Evan has killed 60 points.
No, 59.
Oh, 59 points.
Yeah.
Yeah, right, because he's got the initiative left, so he's got 1 point on the board.
Yep.
So yeah, he's killed 59. And Evans lost 29.
try and 20, focus on 34. Number two. See, the thing is, it doesn't matter. If he only kills one...
Yeah, he needs to kill a lot more.
He loses.
Right.
He needs to kill two. And the only way to kill two is to get number five. And...
Yeah, you know, like...
But you love that we're still predicting moves that would make sense? I mean, that's part of commentating, I think, is yeah. is to discuss what we would do, as if we were experts in some way. We're not. Well, I'm not. I don't know.
I don't really feel like an expert. I play the game
yeah.
pretty darn often.
Yeah.
But...
PTL off the board?
Yeah, why not?
Are you allowed boosting off the board? I mean, the chances of it happening with two dice attacks. So you really hope... Okay, so you hope number two ends up right in front of...
Couldn't, right? Because number two can just do a two straight if he wants to. And just
yeah.
go for a bump.
The moves have been out of this world.
You can do a three hard.
Okay, so he's putting them both in position to shoot number two.
Yeah.
But time's almost up, so...
It doesn't do anything,
yeah.
right?
I assume time's almost up. Let us check with our tournament...
Time is up.
Yeah, tournament organizer. Billy, how are we doing on time? Are they done at... Yeah, this is the last turn? Yeah. So just making sense, making sure this is the last turn, there is nothing that Robin can do to win this game. Unfortunately.
He did make the right call, though. That's High Fighters.
Yep, it's in the right spot to get shot. That being said, he's not going to kill it. Actually, I would barrel roll. Just out of barrel roll behind the rock here.
Agreed.
And, oh, but he didn't. Oh, maybe there's not room. No, there might not be room.
I feel like there's, oh, I don't know, man. Like,
yeah.
if you went front to back on that, there might
yeah.
be space.
And, like, if he gets lucky, if he gets really lucky, he kills number two here, but then game over, you lose on points. Alas. I mean, so if I were Robin, I would have just conceded at this point.
Yeah, no.
Oh, and he just whiffed on his one shot. Or that is the TIE Fighter rolled perfect evades. And there you go.
Man, Evan's evade dice.
That's that. Game over. Ooh, excuse me.
He should fly more swarms with green dice like that.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, shooting at five or seven might have been a good idea. Killing number five could have been great. But the thing is, again, he needed to kill five and three in one turn in order to win. So, because this is the semifinal, MOV doesn't really matter. So here we are. So overall, though, great match. I think it was really difficult for Robin. Just you're gonna have a hard time running X-wings against a crack swarm.
Yeah, and that's the thing with A-wings. When you're counting on them, they don't punch very hard.
No,
they do stay
not.
Alive, and you're using them for those evade results. Is really what they're there for, and lining up range one shots where you might be able to push some damage.
Yeah.
But otherwise, they don't do a lot.
Maybe throwing juke on them or something would be great, but. Alas.